Welcome back. In this lecture, we will configure our wireless adapter to not broadcast its SSID in a way that we make it hidden. So we will be playing the role of an attacker who wants to divulge or reveal that hidden SSID in order to connect to the network, because you cannot connect to the network without knowing the SSID. So usually the people configure their SSID to not being broadcasted within the beacon's frames in order to connect to it to the access point securely by going to the other networks. Then you type the SSID manually and you specify the correct encryption key. Then you connect to the network naturally. So we configure the access point to not broadcast the SSID. And now we will play the role of an attacker who wants to divulge that hidden SSID. So the attacker will normally start by using iwconfig. The access point is already in a monitor mode, fine. Now, the attacker will need to scan the network, now 0, 1. So you can see that our network, let's press Control and C to stop the search. You can notice that this time the network that was configured to use WEP on channel 6, the SSID is not displayed. Okay, let's try to analyze that ourselves using Wireshark. But this time we will use hidden, we will call the file hidden SSID so we can distinguish it from the other. Okay. Error dump, see, and we will save everything into a file. Okay, let's stop it and let's go and analyze that hidden cap. Let's analyze the frames. Okay, so we can see that we have the TP link, so we're gonna use it as a filter. So you go here, you go to the transmitter, the TP link. Let's apply a filter and we type here BSSID. Okay, so as you can see, the TP link broadcasts in the beacon frames. So let's see in the beacon frames, can we find the SSID this time like we did before? Tag parameters, you can see that the SSID is not shown up like before. So you cannot see the SSID here. Okay, so let's go back and see how can we, as an attacker, know the SSID in order to connect to the network. But of course, we need to provide the correct web key, and that's another problem we're gonna take care of later. But first, you will need to divulge or reveal that hidden SSID. Okay, to do that, the attacker will do the following. The attacker will listen only to the access points or to the traffic on channel 6. The attacker will wait for the client to connect to the access point. Once the client connect to the access point, the client will send a probe request containing the SSID to the access point. The access point will respond with the SSID back to the client. So when you hide or when you configure the access point to hide the SSID, you will not show it up in the beacon frame, but still in the probe request and probe responses, the SSID will be there. So an attacker who is continuously listening for that traffic will still be able to intercept the SSID once a legitimate client connect to that network. So I'm going to use my phone right now to connect to the hidden SSID by going to the other networks and type the name of the network, and I'll choose the web key and I'll provide the correct web key to the network. Okay, but before doing that, let me do something. I'm gonna write it to another file. I call it reveal. So we can inspect it and Wireshark to understand more about the packets. So now the client will connect to the, will type the hidden SSID. I'm saying the client because I'm using my phone, okay, as a legitimate user who's gonna connect to that hidden SSID. So I'm gonna type the password. As you can see, once I used my phone to connect to that network, the SSID has been revealed, which is pwned. But how did AeroDump NG utility know that SSID? To understand more, once again, we need to inspect the file we top. We save the file to ls reveal. Wireshark, R-E-V-E-L dot cap. So let's see what happened. So as you can see, again, once again, we're gonna go to TP-Link and we're gonna use it as a filter. BSSID. So as you can see in the beacon frames, the SSID was not there. The SSID was hidden. But there is a probe response here. Let's see what's included inside this. The SSID is shown up, so pwned. So the attacker or the utility has extracted the name pwned from that, the probe response, and showed it to us in the screen from the probe response.